In a horrific case of alleged medical negligence, a family has claimed that their baby died of burns sustained at a hospital in Srinagar. Now, the hospital administration has disputed the family's claim and insisted that the baby, who was admitted with a blood disorder, died on account of it. After outrage raised by the family, now the government has constituted an inquiry committee to look into the matter.
10 hours.
I was in the hospital. The subway but why the subway bilkul oxygen was mis never kade tham to mon baby she can stay the as sub as ya subas dino ta chuti baby as pan matlab asal hisab kit ab jaman maz as amatsan theek the dos badla ims doi three latest diaper wiper was baby jinda winda asal patan so nor war hilawa thoda yet pat kurum ras sada but war do sada kurum phone gay sada bagan over at wish baby does masan the mon wanna see kya dilal tula shore ورد بک تو شنو ڈاکٹر کی اس پان ڈاکٹر اش تاں کیئر کرن اس ہکو کرت تو نیلو کڈی کس واپسی پتہ سے صبحے نظر صبحے بھی نظر تو اس دو
میر فرید جوائنز می وذ مور اون دیٹ ہورریفک سٹوری فرید ٹیل اس واٹ ایکسپلینیشن ڈڈ دی ہسپتال ریلی ہیو فار دی فیکٹ دیٹ دی بیبی ڈڈ گیٹ برنڈ
Well, the hospital administration we spoke to, in fact, we also spoke to the medical superintendent, who on record told us that this is something, this in fact is a blood disorder, and they completely dispute the version of the family. Now, this incident happened the day before yesterday when this infant, this baby was admitted in the hospital after complications. The family, which is from, from a humble background, had come from Kriri to the hospital with the hope of seeing a recovery as far as their child is concerned. Now, the infant was admitted into the intensive care unit, and he was there. Now, the family claimed that he had recovered. In fact, he was also given initially oxygen, and then he was oxygen was removed because his health was recovering. And then all of a sudden, one fine morning, they went in, and when they saw their child, he had burns all over, especially if we talk of feet, legs. They claimed that they were burnt, and after that, they raised hue and cry. The hospital administration came in. Now, the family says that at that time, the medical superintendent and senior doctor admitted that, yes, the night team of doctors had not performed their duty, paramedics, and they will really investigate it and ensure that those who are at fault will be taken to task. But after that, the official statement of the hospital is that this was some serious blood disorder that led to these patches, and these are not burn these are not burn marks, but these are patches because of the medical complication. Now, this is again something that the family is not agreeing upon, and seeing the gravity of this case, the governor's administration immediately appointed a team, in fact a team of doctors who have been given 48 hours to look into it and furnish their report. Now, we'll have to wait for what that report says, but as I said, this is some very grave allegations that have been leveled against the hospital. Although we'll not jump to any conclusion as of now, we'll wait for the report, but if this is proven correct, then this is something that is really horrific. Though the doctors they maintain that the NICU, which is the intensive care unit for these infants, has its own it is basically a specialized unit where a certain temperature is maintained, so they do not need a crude heating device as the family has alleged. So all these things are there, many questions that are unanswered. We'll wait for the official report, and then possibly we'll get to know what exactly had happened. But as of now, as you rightly said, very apparently it seems very horrific. As the family says, these is extremely serious allegations that they have leveled, and that's why this inquiry was really, really very important. Back to you.
Any idea what was this blood disorder that this baby suffered from? How old was this baby?
Well, the baby was a few days old. According to the family, they had initially gone to a private hospital from where the baby was referred to the GB Panth, which is a government hospital, and probably the only hospital in the Kashmir Valley which really is dedicated to the infant medical emergencies and has all the required infrastructure and technology to deal with it. Now, the family went in. They say that initially the doctors immediately took the child into the intensive care unit. He was under supervision. The doctors then claimed that his health is improving. In fact, he was oxygen was also taken away, and he was improving. And then, as I said, one morning they came in, checked the child, and they found these marks all over his feet, which apparently they say there were clear burnt marks. So he was subjected to some kind of a crude heating device that led to this. Now, this is something that the doctors obviously hotly dispute. The administration says that they do not need crude heating devices. It's a specialized unit. It has its temperatures. It has a maintained temperature, and they do not need these things. As I said, this is something the family is disputing. They say that, yes, the child may even have died because of the blood disorder complication. But then, just to downplay the whole affair that he died because of that, and even if there were burn marks, that was not something significant. Now, this is something that obviously is a defense. No one will accept they're in fact demanding an impartial probe and inquiry. We hope that the doctors do their job and this reality in this case is brought out, because if these allegations prove to be even half correct, this is something absolutely unacceptable. This is horrific, and obviously if people are involved in any kind of negligence, especially doctors, they need to be taken to task. Back to you.
Right, Fareed, thank you very much for getting us all of those details, and of course we'll count on you to get us details of the report which the team has to submit within 48 hours. But joining us now is Dr. Suhail Naik, who is the president of the Doctors Association over there. Dr. Naik, thank you very much for taking time out. First up, if you could give us your initial reaction to this. Also, the big question, can a blood disorder cause the kind of patches that we are actually seeing, in your experience?
Yeah, good afternoon, ma'am. I'm, a president of Association of Kashmir, but at the same time, I'm also a pediatrician. From yesterday, we are seeing people, from different quarters of life, including media fraternity and all the netizens of Jammu and Kashmir, they are doing commentary on a photograph. And they are saying that this baby has died because of, burn or heater. But the issue is that, which I want to clear to the people, that DIC and burn marks, they are physically same, because we have experience. We know what when patient goes to DIC, when there occurs clotting inside the blood, the blood supply to limbs get, shut down, and the limbs start swollen, they start discoloration, then vesicles appear. And at the end, the appearance of DIC limb and the burn is same for a non-professional person. But professionally speaking, I want to tell you that if we consider that this burn has happened because of a blower, then it is not possible a blower will burn lower limb of right side and upper limb of left side. That is not possible. Because then to burn opposite side limbs, one upper and one lower, you would need to have two blowers. But to be very honest with my people, we don't have blowers in ICUs. And that too, we don't have that much number of blowers that a patient can get two blowers and the person or hospital staff will put two blowers for a single unit.
Right.
So here, it's prima facie as a professional, it seems to be a case of DIC. But when people who are not, medicos, who are non-professional, for them, it is a burn-like mark. But both the sides should be listed. There should be impartial probe. And personally, I appeal to hospital administration that because CCTV, the ICU of a hospital is continuously monitored under CCTV footage. So I appeal to hospital administration that CCTV footage should be released, and it should be put in public domain. Because Because what is happening in Kashmir, whenever there appears news of any medical negligence in social media, it becomes very much viral because people have a lot of resentment against medical profession.
Right. Dr. Nayak, one more question to you. Like you just pointed out, and let me just recap it for our viewers. What Dr. Nayak is essentially telling us is that in his professional opinion, the baby probably passed away or succumbed to complications because of its blood disorder, much like what the hospital is claiming over here. Those are not burn injuries. But Dr. Nayak also tell us there is a medical team, of course, that has been set up to look into this report, expected within 48 hours. But having said that, do you also think that a lay person or at least a representative from the family side, probably a lawyer or somebody like that, should be part of this team to ensure that the probe is impartial?
Yes, you see, I will tell you one thing. See, if you see a human body while you find a penetrating wound, for non-professional, he may say this is an injury due to iron rod, and somebody will say this is a penetrating wound due to a bullet. But to ascertain the facts, we need to then go to circumstances where the actual injury has happened, and then medical professionals can also, you know, clear the water. But in this inquiry, it is very much important that medical profession, a team of medical professionals should participate to inquire the matter fully. But it is also important that family members, whatsoever, if they will choose a lawyer or they will go personally, they should be part and parcel of this inquiry.
Right.
I am appealing to the hospital authorities that video footage should be made public, so that whole public will learn in future that knee-jerk response to any photograph is not proper and it is not in the, you know, good for the society, in the larger interest of society.
Right. Thank you very much, Dr. Nayak. Also joining me is Wahid Rehman Para, who is a spokesperson of the PDP. Mr. Para, thank you very much for joining us over here. It is a horrific, horrific incident that is being reported out of the GB Pant Hospital. And this is also, like our reporter pointed out to us, the only hospital that the Valley has which actually caters to pediatric emergencies.
Well, this is an unfortunate incident that has happened, and there has been negligence on behalf of the management or on behalf of doctors. But at the same time, we should not just blame only doctors, because these hospitals, particularly the children's hospital, only hospital which is in Kashmir, lacks basic amenities and facilities. We need to ensure that, you know, when a lot is being talked by Prime Minister Narendra Modi of our development, Vikas in Jammu and Kashmir, but very less has happened, honestly, on the infrastructure of health and tertiary health care. So this happened a day when Prime Minister was.
Right.
He talked a lot.
Mr. Para, I'm afraid I have to cut you off there.